The Astute Graphics Art Switcher is a panel for switching the positions of art objects. Because it can work on more than two pieces of art and has flexible options, it can be useful for different things. Let me show you this example here where I have a map with number callouts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, going clockwise. And I want to replace these numbers with the red numbers over here. And I also want to make these run in the opposite order, so counterclockwise, starting with 1, 2, 3, and so on. So normally I would be dragging this call out over here, lining it up, and then removing the one behind it and doing this for each number individually. But the AG Art Switcher panel is going to do this so much faster. So the first step is to open the panel. Let's go up to the window menu and down to Astute Graphics and then Art Switcher. Now I have all my numbers on one layer, so it's easy to select them over in the Layers panel by clicking the empty space there. And so with them all selected, in the Art Switcher panel, there are three buttons that you can click here at the bottom to switch the art. I'll click the Cycle Down button. And as I do this, you'll see one by one, the red numbers are moving into position on the map and the black numbers are now off to the side. So that completes the first part of my task. Next, I need to reorder the numbers on the map to move them clockwise. Everything is still selected, so I'll just hold Shift to marquee over the black numbers to deselect those. And now I can begin switching among the red numbers. First, number one, it's in the right place. So I'm going to deselect that, holding Shift as I click. And then I need the number two to move in place of number six. So I'll click Cycle Up. Now it's in the right place, so I'll deselect it and click Cycle Up again to move three into the right place. Then I'll deselect that and cycle up again, deselect the number four and switch the last two out. So that happened much faster than it would have if I had to move everything by hand. So now that you've seen what you can do with the AG Art Switcher panel, let's take a closer look at how it works. Here I have just three numbers to keep things simple. And as you saw in the last example, when I click on these buttons, I'm switching the position of the artwork on the artboard. But these buttons cycle down and cycle up are also referring to the stacking order in the Layers panel. So when I cycle down, number one, which is on top of the stacking order, moves downward. And when I cycle up, number one cycles to the bottom of the order and then moves upward through the stacking order. And randomize is just going to mix things up randomly. But if I want to keep the stacking order intact, I have that option. I'll go ahead and reorder these. So now we've got 1, 2, 3, and the numbers are selected on the artboard. And here's the checkbox, keep stacking order and grouping. And I'll check this to keep the numbers in their original stacking order. So now as I click any of these buttons at the bottom of the panel, I'm switching the art's position, but nothing's moving in the stacking order over in the Layers panel. And this checkbox also refers to groups. So let's take a look at that. Here, I have a group of hearts with an AG block shadow effect applied to them at the group level. And we can see that group over here in the Layers panel. It's on a separate layer. And then just like before, I have my 1, 2, 3 all stacked up. So let's say I want to switch between all of this art here, and I'm leaving the keep stacking order and grouping checkbox checked. And now when I cycle the art, you can see the stacking order and the grouping in the Layers panel stays exactly as it was. And we're just switching the position of the objects on the artboard. Now, if I want, I can select only the green heart here inside that group, just clicking it with the direct selection tool. And then I'll also select the number two, and I want to switch between these two objects. So when I click the cycle button, there's switching position on the artboard, but you can see in the Layers panel, the heart group stays intact. And you can see how the hearts get farther apart and then closer together within the group as I click. So that's keep stacking order and grouping checked. Now let's uncheck that checkbox and see what happens. If I do the same thing, switching only the green heart and the number two, the green heart changes position on the artboard and it also moves out of the heart group and into the layer with the numbers. And the number two is now inside that heart group. It's got the drop shadow applied, that group appearance, and its position keeps switching on the artboard and in the Layers panel as I click that button. So that's the keep stacking order and grouping checkbox unchecked. Now, as we've been switching this art, the position is oriented to the center of the bounding box of each object. And that's a setting you can control right here. If you're not working with shapes like this and you're working with open paths, try experimenting with the first and last anchor options. These are great when you're switching open path artwork. Now that you know the basics, run some experiments on your own artwork, your technical drawings, diagrams, and maps, and discover just how much time the AG Art Switcher panel can save you.